Hello, welcome back. Fit is saying here at Caffeinated Gaming, wearing my fancy schmancy tux, and apparently I just changed my skins a little bit, trying to find something that kind of screams newscaster. And well, I went for a tux, and then I found another skin, and now I can't change them because there's limits. But today's Tuesday. That means gaming news, releases, and sales. So today we have three basic news articles: Metro Last Light controversy, Rift going free to play, and the year of the digital TCG. These aren't necessarily maybe the biggest news in gaming of the week, but hey, there are three that just kind of spoke to me. First up, we have Metro Last Light. It launched yesterday and has been met with quite a bit of controversy over at a lot of websites, including Reddit and some of the major news type websites. We've been hearing a lot of people complaining about the pre-order bonus. So Metro Last Light has been getting mediocre to good reviews, but people are pointing out some of the game is not without issues. First and foremost, the big bugbear, as I think Total Biscuit would call it, is the Ranger mode. It is an optional hardcore difficulty for players that focuses on scarcity and maybe some little more realism. The developer stated that this is the way the game is meant to be played, right on their website. But the mode was only available either as a pre-order bonus or for a $5 DLC. When asked why, 4A said, "Game makers and publishers are now live in a world where offering game content as a pre-order exclusive is a requirement by retail, and Ranger mode seemed to be the best choice. It was a mode for hardcore fans who most likely would pre-order the game or purchase at its launch in any case." He says, "We rejected requests to make story content additional mission exclusives. Also rejected requests to make this a timed exclusive." Part of me wants to say that, all right, so this is going to be an issue with pre-order culture. There's recently been a backlash against pre-ordering games, especially when there's no significant reason to. A lot of games nowadays are either just wanting you to pre-order because it looks good for the company, they don't offer you anything for it, or they'll do the tiered pre-order bonuses that Steam's been doing lately. And maybe since people have been kind of backing off saying, "Well, fine, I just won't pre-order, I'll wait till review," maybe retailers are kind of pushing back, and then they're forcing publishers and developers to offer exclusives and bonuses. If the retailers are truly forcing games to put in bonuses, then I got some sympathy for 4A. That said, Ranger difficulty was a paid-for DLC on the Xbox 360, I believe. So if they've added it and charged for it in the past, I don't know if Microsoft forced that on them or not, but that's a tough call. Either way, I'm not a fan of that. I'm always fine with games going ahead and offering DLC when the developers are finished with the game. They got some more work to do, so they go ahead and they create more content and sell it later. But I'm not a fan with them slicing off content and then selling it to us piecemeal. Sell me the game that you worked on. I'll pay for it, whatever the price is. If you want to charge me $55 instead of $50, then charge me $55. Don't charge me $50. That said, I did pre-order the game because I want to look at it, and I do want to post some content and eventually first impressions for it. But that said, brings me to the next topic of the game. The game's graphics are also giving players headaches, literally. The PC version of Last Light is missing several key options, including FOV sliders. I haven't watched the WTF is yet, but I can only assume that's a big issue. And there's also no way in-game to switch down to DirectX 9, and no way to turn off aim assist. Players can work around those last two issues by going into the config files, but there's actually no way to edit FOV from when I was reading this morning. If you tend to get sick from low FOV, I'd maybe wait and see if 4A fixes the problem before buying the game. $50 if you're going to get sick and not be able to enjoy it, skip it. One of the reasons why I haven't actually gotten into it yet is I don't really get sick from low FOV, but it does kind of give me a feeling of vertigo and just kind of awkwardness, I guess I could say. I do get vertigo from games. I don't really get sick, headache, nausea like some people report, but just a little bit irritating to me. Really annoying that games are still porting to PC and not offering this. It's surprising considering, I mean, you've got a pretty big community saying, "This game makes me sick, I can't play it, can't enjoy it." So hopefully it's something they plan to fix in the future. Next up, we have Rift going free-to-play on June 12th. Treyarch's Hit Games going to go change our free-to-play model. Players that purchase the game and Storm Legion will get everything they've had for a while new players will be limited to 2 characters and 3 back slots. Normally, it is, 6 characters and 5 back slots? There will be a microtransaction store added to the game. It sells mounts, gear, boosts, companion pets, and more. Treyarch has stated that this will not be a pay-to-win game, but I'm going to be interested to see what kind of gear is in the store. They said the best gear will still come from playing the game, but if it's good enough gear, I can only imagine people might get a little annoyed. There's also going to be a subscription tier called Patrons. You get rewards. Patron rewards include 15% more in-game currency. Ooh, that's going to hurt the economy a little bit. A daily XP boost. No big deal. Instant access to your bank and guild and trainer. Okay, convenience. Get boosts for daily currencies. Again, economy. And have a faster mount. That one I'll get into in a minute. And daily bonuses for PvP XP and reputation. Extra notoriety, extra rewards the longer you subscribe. So, the one I'm really a little bit worried about is 10% mount speed. I don't honestly remember if you can mount up in PvP. But if you can, movement speed is very important. And just in general, movement speed is important. I am interested to see if it's going to have an effect, but this thing I'm looking forward to checking out. I will be looking at the game probably next month when it goes free to play. I have not played since before Storm Legion. I played a lot at release for a few months. I played a wizard, and my favorite build was probably Chloromancer, I think. Chloromancer was probably my favorite build. It wasn't necessarily the best, but it was the one I had the most fun with. And next up, this one is kind of speaking to me right now. This, I swear, must be the year of the digital TCG. I actually got a message from WW Knight, who is a major supporter of Infinity Wars, and someone also posts a lot of content for that game. I will leave his link in the description. He introduced me to an upcoming digital TCG called Hex. It's from Cryptozoic. And it's currently getting kickstarted. As of this recording, the game has fundraised $440,000 and is working on stretch goals. Cryptozoic has produced several games that I've enjoyed in the past. Penny Arcade, it's a digital deck building game, very similar to other deck builders, but cool sense of humor, and the first expansion to it was actually really good. The Big Bang Theory game, basically an apples-to-apples spin-off, but with Big Bang Theory theme, feel to it. Played it at Gen Con last year. Pretty good fun, although I have to say I prefer Cards Against Humanity. And they're also the creators of the WoW TCG, which I honestly have never played. Sorry. And not to be confused with the upcoming Hearthstone, for anyone that's like me and hasn't played WoW TCG. Hex combines elements of TCGs with MMOs. Players can create or join guilds, complete dungeons, fight against supposedly advanced AI, and more. Some of the other points Hex points out are on the Kickstarter page include tournament play, so competitive play is always good, unlocking cards by playing the game, and focusing on a story. As someone who posts plenty of content of digital TCGs lately, I can only... I'm pretty sure I'm going to kickstart it and see if I can get into the beta. I'm also kind of a fan of Cryptozoic. I've liked their games in the past, so expect to see some content from that when it's... goes ahead and gets into beta. The Kickstarter ends on June 7th, so if you're interested in backing it, look for the description below, the comment below, and go support it. Now for new releases this week. Technically, I last week was counting Monday as last week, so I already mentioned Metro Last Light, but from now on, I'm going to start on Mondays, even though I'm posting these on Tuesdays. Sanctum 2! It's a 3D shooter, tower defense, which releases on May 15th. I will be posting coverage on the channel once I get my hands on the game. It's available for $15, and I pre-ordered it on Steam, and I'm planning to go and show it off. I was a fan of Sanctum 1. I was also a fan of some of the fan DLC, or the fun DLC they did last year. Thunderwolves, seeing as I've been in the guild called Tempest Wolves, I'm just kind of amused by the name, but it's a helicopter action game that includes local co-op, so no online co-op as of yet. It's due out on the 15th, and it is for sale for $12 over on Steam. They currently have 20% off. By the way, Sanctum 2 is also released tomorrow, too. Anomaly 2. Anomaly is another tower defense game, but it's got twist. It's a tower offense game. The game is due out on the 15th also. You can get 10% by pre-ordering through Steam, and it's available for $13.49. All games are regular price at $15, so pretty good week for indie titles, and again, Metro Last of Light already released. For sales, I'm going to find a few sales. Hitman Absolution. It's currently half off at Steam. Bring it to $12.49. I've actually picked it up during the Christmas sale. I've never played it. Oh, why don't I play some of the games that I have? Damn you, Steam sale culture. And Saints Row the Third, the full package. It's on sale at Green Man Gaming for $16.99. It looks like it has an ass ton of DLC, so go check that out. I have not tried Saints Row the Third yet. Got some friends that are huge fans of it, and I probably will be trying to play it at some point. And last but not least, if anyone hasn't played it, The Witcher 2 is on sale at Green Man Gaming for $9.99. The Witcher 2 is an amazing game, and I know probably a lot of people have played it because it got pirated to hell, but it might be worth going to support them. They're a really cool developer. They've made a really good game. The book series is fun. It's in Polish, though, and they're translating it slow as hell. But I would definitely consider supporting it. I already have the game. I've played through it twice. I keep wanting to go back and play through it again. It's probably one of my favorite RPGs. It's been out released in the last quite a few years. That's it for this week. Thanks for watching. Hopefully I'll get some of my quirks ironed out. I do want to include video clips in the future. If anyone has any ideas for keeping me from getting third-party strikes on my channel, I would love to put them on here. I also am looking to get some music. I'm going to ask the Infinity Wars guys if I can use some of their new music they just released in the patch. And I want to do some editing on these videos. Got to work on some stuff. And I do want to get some kind of decorations in the studio. And also I'm trying to look for new skin. Thanks for watching. See you guys over the course of the week. Have a great week. Bye.